Happy Sunday morning. Today it's a very colourful show because we're hanging with a pop superstar, a phenomenon out of the UK. It's Mika, and we're talking about the new album, or the debut album, Life in Cartoon Motion. And
pop superstar.
Well, you are, really. I mean, would you say you're a bit of a superstar these days?
A bit of a pop tart.
A pop tart?
Yeah.
In like an edible way, or in a...
Yeah, have you heard those have been banned?
Have they?
I think they've been banned, yeah, because kids were burning their tongues on them.
Really?
Yeah, they were heating up the Pop-Tarts. And
they actually are pretty hot, now that I think about it. That's amazing that they have that kind of care for kids these days, isn't it? Now, we're sitting here in the wardrobe room at Channel 10, and it's mainly girl stuff, I'm sorry. I tried to arrange some colourful bloke stuff. but did you think our newsreaders would look good wearing this kind of thing?
Is this newsreader clothes?
Some of it definitely is.
I do wonder where people get the clothes from sometimes on TV shows. Like, I did Jay Leno in the States.
Yeah.
And he has stacks and stacks of suits, and they were really fussing over what he was going to wear. He looks absolutely identical to me every single night. I don't know what the big deal is.
Yeah, it's a bit like Richie Beno in Australia, the off-white, the ivory. Oh, is that your favourite so far?
It's quite nice, isn't it?
What do you do with that, around the shoulders?
Thanks very much for my bling, by the way.
Yeah, oh, you're welcome.
You are an accessories bandit.
Yeah. It's only because I buy all this stuff and then I have to walk through customs, so I put it on so I don't have to play duty.
Oh, okay. I learned that
from a friend of mine.
There's so many things you can learn on this show, isn't there? All right, now, I saw recently that you played a big festival in the UK and you hurt yourself. Bit of an ankle injury. Is that right?
Oh, yeah.
BBC Radio 1?
Well, actually, it's a recurring injury. It's just here on my leg, and
right.
every time I jump around on stage, it just, I don't know what it is. I've been to physios, they don't know what it is. It just kind of hurt all the muscles here. They just kind of go into spasm.
Right.
I think it's just months of touring without stopping. I've been touring now for about 9 months around the world and haven't really stopped. So I think it just takes its toll on your muscles.
Yeah, well, fair enough.
It's quite pathetic because everyone's sitting around drinking beers and I just, after a gig, I'm sitting around with the paramedics getting bandaged up and, you know.
You can still do that and drink beer.
Well, not really.
Just put the foot out. Now we're going to check out the first big single, Grace Kelly, and I just love that this was originally written as a big sort of up yours to record company in particular.
It was written as a big screw you to the music industry. Ironically, of course, it ended up being the first single, but I never wrote it as a song to even go on an album. I just wrote it as a personal message to the people I was working with. Saying, you know, well, you want me to be a certain way, but I'm going to be myself and get lost. Ironically, it, you know, it kind of helped me out in my career.
I certainly did. Big number one smash. Well, let's have a look at it. And we're going to be talking to pop superstar, Pop-Tart Mika.
Pop-Tart.